Hey everybody, and welcome to my 36-week pregnancy update for baby number 3. This will officially be my second to last pregnancy vlog in this pregnancy, if all goes well, that is. If everything, all my appointments go well this week, then I'll make it to 37 weeks and I'll make one more video before my induction next Monday, a week today. And if you're not familiar with what I'm talking about, I'll leave links down below to all the updates, but my induction is set for March 9th, so this is potentially and most likely my second to last pregnancy vlog, which is insane. This pregnancy already went really fast, and now with this thrown in the mix, I just can't believe it's ending. I'm excited to meet this baby, and I hope this baby is healthy and, you know, want to do what's best for baby, but it's just overwhelming that it's ending so quickly. I have so many things to talk about. It's hard to keep track of everything because every day something else is happening. I'm actually thinking about maybe recording daily vlogs up until my induction date. So let me know in a comment down below if you want to see that. I don't know if I'd record everything I was doing because I am technically supposed to be on like modified bed rest. So I'm not super active, but at least I could update day to day as to how my appointments are going and kind of what I'm doing with the kids and things like that leading up to my induction. Let me know if you'd like to see that. But I think last update was last Wednesday when I met with maternal fetal medicine. Since then, I'm part of the antepartum home care group, and it's a group of nurses that actually come to my house, which has been awesome. They came on Thursday and they did a non-stress test. Was it Thursday? I think it was Thursday. Baby was sleeping, so the non-stress test took a while, but that went fine, and I had to fill out a chart and just tell them how many hours a day I'm laying down, if I have any contractions, just stuff like that. And then they called me on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday to check in on my chart and check in on how I'm doing, and then they're coming in today. So that's good. I have people checking on me. Today, this morning, I also had my midwife appointment, which I'm going to go over in a minute. And then this upcoming week, I have 2 ultrasounds. I have to go in to maternal fetal medicine for those, and then 2 more non-stress tests where they come to my house. So that is kind of what's happening right now. I guess I'll just jump into my midwife appointment. It was almost an hour long again. It's my last midwife appointment, and I'm thankful though to say that they're going to do shared care. So the midwife is going to attend the induction. I'm not losing my midwives, which is awesome because I still have yet to meet the OB that's going to deliver my baby. I've been referred a week ago and haven't heard anything back yet. It's possible I won't meet this OB till the day of my induction. I'm well aware of that, but at least my midwives will be there advocating for me as much as they can. Questions I asked her is, could I still have as many people in the room as I wanted? Could I still photograph? Could I still like take video? Because I plan to video the birth, and even though it's going to be a small baby, and she said, yep, no problem. So it's going to be my husband in the room. My sister's going to be taking video. Husband? Sister? I feel like there's somebody else. There's the photographer who I had scheduled for my home birth. I was unsure as to whether or not I still wanted to use her, but I decided, you know what, I'd rather have the memories, no matter what they are. I'd rather have the memories. My photographer's gonna be there. I feel like there was somebody else, but maybe I'm forgetting. Hope not. And then the midwife, obviously, and the OB, and she said just be prepared for a really full room if baby needs extra care and things like that, like a pediatrician. So that's good. I asked her about laboring, because I really don't like to be strapped down to a bed. That's the whole reason I wanted a home birth. I wanted to be able to go in and out of a shower and a tub, use a birth ball, walk around, potentially not even. Like, I really don't want to be on my back in stirrups when I'm pushing the baby out. It's just the most uncomfortable position for me. But knowing that I'm delivering with an OB, I asked her what she thinks about that, and she said basically that it's going to be a lot harder to kind of get what I want out of a birth, and that I need to be prepared for that. And I knew that. She said that they have some wireless monitors, and she'll try and get those, because baby needs to be monitored the whole time. She'll try and get those for me so that I can walk around, but there's a good chance they're going to request me to be in the bed. She said if baby comes out healthy, like if everything's going well and the midwife delivers the baby, then she has no problem delivering in whatever position I end up in. But if it's an OB, she said that I need to be prepared to be on my back in stirrups. Which, I mean, is what it is. birth plan. I've never actually written down a birth plan before. I've never felt the need to. And I asked her if I should do that this time around since I have so many preferences and things that I was, you know, hoping for. And she said absolutely, especially since there's going to be a lot more like people involved with the OB and a lot more nurses and things like that, that if I can just write down my preferences, it'll be easier for them to advocate for me. And then I just need to keep in mind that whatever's going to happen is going to happen. And I get that. Whatever's best for baby, I'm going to put right on there that interventions need to take place for the health of the baby come first. But on top of that, I have a whole bunch of preferences. And there's too many to honestly list in this video, because I think this video is going to be long as it is. So I'm thinking about doing a birth plan video if you want to see what my ideal preferences are if baby's okay. I talked to her about placenta encapsulation because that's something I wanted to do this time around. And I actually had set up somebody already, and then I just thought maybe I should ask her about that since this baby is not quite your typical birth. And she said that most likely the OB is going to send the placenta off to pathology to make sure there was nothing wrong with the placenta itself. And once it's sent off to pathology, you can't get it back to do encapsulation. So that's disappointing. She said I could still put it on my birth plan in case he decides not to, but most likely it's going to pathology, so that sucks. What else? I brought in all my birth kit stuff. If you watched my home birth kit video, I brought in all the stuff that I am not transferring to my hospital bag, and I asked her if I could donate it if there's any families in need, and she said absolutely. So that makes me feel good. All that stuff is not going to waste. It's going to be going to families who need that stuff and can't afford their own home birth supplies for whatever reason, so that's good. And the birth pool itself, which I have now, it's behind me, you can't see it, in a box. We're gonna put up an ad because she says there are a lot of people that are looking to buy one at the midwife place, so we are gonna sell off the birth pool. So there are a plan for both of those, which is good. And then the last thing is she asked if it'd be okay if she checked me. And I knew that was an option. I was thinking she was even going to try a sweep, but I wasn't sure if it was too early. I'm 36 weeks now. Normally I wouldn't be doing these things till like 38, 39 weeks, but because we know we're heading into an induction, she just was curious how things were coming along, and I was too. And I told her, I'm like, I'm pretty sure I'm going to be long, firm, and closed, if you know anything about cervixes. Basically, like, no progress. I'm only 36 weeks, so that's what I was totally anticipating. And she checked me, and the cervix is like a funnel, basically, so this like outside portion can open, whereas the inside can be closed. So the outside portion is actually open 3 centimeters, which is good news. Something is happening. The inside is closed, which is normal. She said it's shortening and it's getting soft, so things are actually moving along. And she actually, when she first went to check, she's like, oh, baby's head is right here. I wouldn't have expected baby to be engaged at this point. So those are all good things. She couldn't do a sweep or anything, so I'm still, the inside os is closed. But at 36 weeks, to have any progress at all is a really good sign. It hurt like crazy. I hate being checked, and it reminds me of what I'm about to go through with induction and labor, and it just, I'm not ready. I'm just not ready. I'm nervous about it, but it's a week. It's a week from now, so I need to get my head in the game and know that that's what's coming. I think part of the reason that I did make some progress is because I saw my naturopath last Thursday, who's also a midwife, and asked her to start me on. It's called Mother's Cordial. It's like a tincture thing. I used it with all my pregnancies, and my midwife has something similar too, like a tea you can make. This is like a actual concentrate of a whole bunch of herbs and stuff that help prep your cervix and soften you and dilate you and get your uterus ready and things like that. So I've been taking that since last Thursday. And also red raspberry leaf tea. She has like a concentrate of it, which is also in liquid form, so I've been taking that as well. And kind of like an evening primrose oil, but a bit different. Whole bunch of things, basically. A whole bunch of supplements I've started in the past 5 days or so, just to start things, prepping my body for getting ready for labor, so that hopefully induction will take a little bit easier than it will if I did nothing. I'm really hoping to avoid oxytocin or Pitocin at all costs. I'm okay with the prostaglandin gel, I believe it's called, or Cervidil. I'm okay if they're with them breaking my water if they think that's the best route. but oxytocin is not my preference. And again, I'll get more into that in my birth plan video. But yeah, anything I can do to prep my body. She also suggested I go see an acupuncturist. She had one that specializes just in getting your body ready for labor, which I thought was interesting. And so she doesn't recommend I start that until like 3 or 4 days before the induction, because I guess she's that effective. I don't know. So I have her information. I might be checking out an acupuncturist. As far as symptoms this past week, honestly, I've just been really emotional. Clearly it's a lot to cope with and deal with, and I go through spurts of being really positive and optimistic, and then I go through spurts of being really anxious and scared and worried, and it's it's back and forth. Braxton Hicks are picking up, probably because I'm doing all those supplements, so they're getting stronger and there's more of them and they're more intense, so that's all good things. Nauseous. I don't know why, but yesterday, I was really nauseous on Thursday. Friday and Saturday, I was okay, just waves of it. Yesterday, it was like I got hit with the flu, and I knew it wasn't the flu. I knew it wasn't a sickness, but literally, I felt like I was on the verge of barfing, like throwing up all day long, morning to night. All I could do is lay on my side and close my eyes, but I wasn't sleeping because I couldn't sleep. And I couldn't open my eyes because it made me even more nauseous. And I couldn't read, I couldn't watch any shows. I like laid in bed for hours and hours and hours and hours yesterday. I don't know. I was supposed to film yesterday. I couldn't even film. I couldn't even put makeup on. I couldn't get myself dressed. I couldn't do anything. I was like totally out of it. This morning's kind of been go, 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 so I'm okay at this point. I was really nauseous driving to my midwife and while I was sitting there, but now I'm feeling okay that I'm filming, and the nurse is about to come over, so today's busier, so I don't know if that has something to do with it, but holy heck, really, really nauseous. Do I think there's anything else? Yeah, I think that's pretty much it. One exciting thing is, I was going to mention that we hadn't picked a name yet for this baby until last night. If it was a boy, this baby's had a name for years, like since before Kayla. But if it's a girl, we haven't been set on a name until I think, last night, we finally settled on a name and a middle name if this baby's a girl. So that's exciting, because I had these fears that the baby was going to be here and we wouldn't know what to name her if it was a girl, so that's exciting. Done lots of work in the nursery, prepped the cloth diapers, they're all ready, even though this baby won't be able to fit into them probably in the beginning. That's ready. Clothes are ready. What else? Just, you know, finishing up like loose ends and things like that. I do plan to record a nursery tour once the nursery is done. I know I've been getting that question a lot in my question and answers video. So once it's done, I'm still waiting on some things, then I will. Baby will obviously be here before it's recorded, but it is what it is. But what else did I want to mention? I did a hospital bag video and a home birth kit video this week, if you want to check those out below. I will do my answers video this week, along with my birth plan video this week, and maybe even third trimester must-haves. Plan to record that this week, so there's going to be a lot of videos, and all of those possibly on top of daily vlogs, if that's something you guys are interested in. Yes, I think that's it for now. I hope you guys are all doing well. Thank you so much for watching, and all the sweet, kind comments and words of advice that you always leave down in the comments. They're so awesome to read, and I'll leave my belly shot at the end, and hopefully, fingers crossed, I see you guys for my 37-week update next week. My midwife did say, remember, if any of your tests don't look so great, they're going to send you that day for an induction. So kind of living on pins and needles right now, but hoping I make it to 37 weeks. And yeah, I'll see you guys later. Bye. All right, here's the 36-week belly from the front. And then from the side, there is definitely no lack of weight gain. From myself, I did mention, but I've gained almost 40 pounds now in this pregnancy. If only more of my weight gain would go to the baby, we'd be in better shape. But yeah, I feel like it did get bigger this week. I don't know, let me know what you guys think. But that's the 36-week belly.